Komodo dragons are the largest lizards in the world and the largest venomous animal on Earth. They're endemic to a select few Indonesian islands, these being their namesake Komodo Island, as well as Rinca, Flores, and Gili Motang. As the largest of the monitor lizards, the max length that adults will reach is 3 meters and sometimes even a bit longer. Like all reptiles, the Komodo dragon is an ectotherm, which means it regulates its temperature based on its environment. So in earlier times of the day, the dragon will find a sunny spot to warm up and rest, and then become more active. In much hotter and warmer parts of the day, the dragon will retreat to the shelter of the cooler forest, or potentially even a water source. The species was only discovered last century in 1910. An expedition to Komodo Island to study the dragons in 1926 was the inspiration behind the story of King Kong, a mysterious island isolated from the rest of civilization, full of giant creatures. In isolation on these small islands, this monitor is the apex predator of the islands it inhabits. With no larger mammalian predators to challenge it, it has evolved to become the top predator. Their closest relative is the Australian lace monitor, with a common ancestor diverging from the arboreal crocodile monitor of New Guinea. Fossils found in Queensland, Australia suggest that this lizard once did inhabit the northern parts of the continent, spanning from the early Pliocene to the middle Pleistocene. However, Komodo dragons are not the biggest of the monitor lizards, as back in the Pleistocene, Australia was also inhabited by a giant known as Megalania, or alternatively, Varanus priscus, with estimates placing its length between 3.5 to even 7 meters in length, which would have been truly colossal. Like all monitor lizards, they do not possess the best eyesight nor hearing abilities. So in place of this, monitor lizards, like snakes, will taste the air with a long forked tongue that assists in tracking prey and mates. The particles that are picked up by this tongue are analyzed in the Jacobson's organ in the roof of their mouth, that determines the direction in which an animal has moved in. Their jaws are equipped with around 60 serrated teeth that are covered by gums, and when feeding or biting, these teeth come forward and lacerate the other animal. They adopt many other characteristics of monitor lizards: long hook claws to assist in grip, combat, and digging nests, as well as a long, well-muscled tail that assists in the dragon swimming, as well as doubling as a weapon with a force similar to that of a sledgehammer when used in attacks. Extra protection are the osteoderms beneath their skin, which act like a suit of armor and help the dragon repel the claws, bites, and tail swipes of other dragons. They live in hot, dry places, in open grassy areas, and tropical forests. They are a largely diurnal animal, doing most of their hunting during the day, but have been known to exhibit nocturnal activity. As I mentioned before, the Komodo dragon is ectothermic. So in cooler times of the day, the dragon would appear much colder in a thermal imaging camera, and then in the warmer times they would appear much brighter and warmer. To avoid heat, dragons will dig holes using their powerful claws. These dens can be 3 meters deep, capable of sheltering the whole lizard in the cooler soil. They have also been known to use caves as a method of shelter. In the heat of the day, Komodo dragons will frequent open areas, and will often be seen sleeping near the ocean to catch breezes as a method of cooling. These open areas can also be used as potential locations for an ambush on passing prey, like goats, deer, wild boar, monkeys, and water buffalo. As large carnivores, they feed on many of the animals that can be found on their islands. They'll often scavenge on carrion and washed-up animals on the shoreline, such as sea turtles and fish. These lizards, however, cannot breathe and run the same way that mammals can, and so try to ambush their prey rather than persist in a long chase. To assist with this problem, monitor lizards possess a large throat pouch that will fill with air to assist in running, bringing down prey, and while fighting one another, increasing their endurance. If a dragon can avoid hunting, it will, and a single carcass will attract many lizards to feast. They are communal feeders, with many dragons feeding from a single carcass at once. Despite this gathering, however, the dragons are not affiliated with one another, rather just taking advantage of a free meal. It was previously speculated that the drooling saliva of Komodo dragons was filled with bacteria and would cause sepsis after biting prey, but in fact they have very good mouth hygiene, frequently licking their jaws. Instead of this, a study done in 2005 found that monitor lizards like parentes, lace monitors, and Komodo dragons had a venom that causes swelling, a shooting pain, and also possessing an anticoagulant. An anticoagulant prevents blood from clotting, and after the dragon bites with its serrated teeth, raking the animal with them, animals like a buffalo will die of shock and blood loss rather than from bacterial infection. In the breeding season, males will engage in a spectacular confrontation, which will involve them standing on their hind legs and wrestling with one another, using their powerful forelimbs and biting with their jaws, and using their own body weight will pin the loser to the ground, like a wrestling match to guarantee victory. A rarity among lizards is the case of monogamous pairing, with males and females creating lasting bonds with one another. The females will create a camouflaged nest hole to avoid the discovery and cannibalism by other dragons. The clutch of up to 20 eggs will incubate in the ground for 7 to 8 months. Being much smaller and more vulnerable to predation, the hatchlings will spend their early years high up in the treetops away from the adults and feed on a diet of smaller reptiles and insects before maturing at 8 to 9 years of age and can live for over 30 years. A discovery was made in a captive environment that Komodo dragons can reproduce through a process known as parthenogenesis, where the female, without fertilization by the male, will lay eggs, but all hatch as males, with the lack of the male's chromosomes being a major factor. It is incredible, but does hold its risks, as all male hatchlings with the genetics to produce females lacking, it can lead to reduction in genetic diversity. Since their scientific discovery, the Komodo dragon has been displayed in captivity worldwide, being an impressive and popular species. Many individuals can become surprisingly tame in a short amount of time, and despite their poor eyesight and hearing, they have been capable of distinguishing between familiar and unfamiliar people, such as their keepers and guests, showing that they are capable of recognition. They will even engage with many other objects, and have even been target trained. In 2021, the Komodo dragon was reclassified from vulnerable to endangered. Many issues have threatened the dragon in recent years, and their vulnerability is likely due to their island isolation, with man-made threats being a primary cause of this. In 1980, the Komodo National Park was created to help protect the dragons and to assist in their conservation. Being found in Indonesia, many geological threats have actually threatened the dragon, volcanic activity and earthquakes to name a few, as well as wildfires, loss of prey, the tourism of their island, which has also been limited in recent years to avoid potential poaching, has significantly affected the dragon's numbers. In the long run, however, Komodo dragons are threatened by climate change, as well as many other species. With the reedification of their island and the sea level rise would reduce their habitat. There are an estimated 4,000 or more dragons remaining in the wild, many thought to be hatchlings. Successful breeding in captivity can help prevent the extinction of the species through the creation of an insurance population with a varied gene pool to sustain them in captivity. A magnificent predator that is like a remnant of a bygone age. On the island of Komodo and surrounding islands, it is like returning to a world dominated by reptiles. This endangered but incredible reptile deserves its fame and protection. If you love Komodo dragons and would love to see more, please subscribe to the channel and like the video if you enjoyed it. Leave any suggestions you might have in the comments below, and I'll see you guys in the next species profile.